Together, the point was to work through these relatively quickly, okay? Made this function a little simpler than yesterday. We took a lot of time working those outputs, right? Getting those y values yesterday. So we're gonna work through these real quick. We're gonna change up this negative 1 or negative 2. Right? A lot of the work is gonna look the same with just a different number. We're gonna put negative 2, we're gonna square that number. We're gonna multiply negative 2, this negative 2 here, by a negative 2. Because we're working out negative 2. We get negative 2 times negative 2.
4.
Okay, that'll be 4. Okay, we're gonna subtract a 2 times a negative 2. That's a negative 2 times a negative 2, which is a positive 4. Again, plus 1. This is 5, so 4 plus 5. Is 9, or you have 4 plus 4 is 8 plus 1 is 9, or however you work it out, you should have 9 here. Alright. Now 0. When you plug 0 into the function, you should, like, when you see that that's what you're supposed to do, you should kind of do a little dance of joy, because that is pretty easy. When I plug 0 in and I square it, what do I get?
It's 1.
0. I don't even have to, like, write that out. 0 times 0 is 0. What's negative 2 times 0?
0.
So all the stuff that has x in it, because x is being multiplied by something,
this
is 0. So we wind up having 0 plus 1, which is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. So that doesn't even require us to write anything down. All right, scratch all this out, and start again with 1. What's 1 times 1? 1 squared is?
1 minus
1. Negative 2 times 1.
Negative 2.
Negative 2 plus 1. So we have 1 minus 2, which is negative 1, plus 1 is
0.
Or we have 1 plus 1 is 2, minus 2 is 0. Okay. So we have
0.
All right, let's get rid of this. And we got the 2. 2 squared is 2 times 2. All right, 2 squared means 2 times 2. What's 2 times 2?
4. Wait, what's
this? Comes next, negative 2 times 2. What's negative 2 times 2?
Negative 4.
Plus 1. All right, so we have 4 minus 4.
0.
Plus 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. All right, last one. At least for now. The goal here is we're trying to get unintimidated by graphs. Graphs are not an intimidating thing. You can plug things into the function and get things out. You can graph a graph. Plug in 3 here. 3 squared means?
3 times
3. Okay, next comes negative 2 times 3.
Negative 6
plus 1 times 3 is 9. Careful there. Make sure you don't get 6, 3 times 3, 9 minus 6 is 3, plus 1,
4.
Now, you notice anything about those numbers?
Yeah, it goes 4, 1, 0, 1, 4.
So there's like kind of a symmetry, right? Like the same on the left side as the right side, but these kind of be in the middle.
Yep.
Okay, now let's take a look at a graph. Everything's pretty much in the positives here. So we'll, well, everything is except for the x's. Okay. So we're going to plot these points. And it's as simple as here is enough information for one point. Can someone plot this point?
Yes.
Come on up.
You
want to plot the point? Given by the circled.
This is hard.
Doing well.
Great.
Good.
I'm
How about pass it back to Katie.
In this one.
Katie can choose who to pass to next. That's upside down. Okay. All right, he's gonna move on to the next one, -1, 4.
Don't
cross the line. -1, 4.
Go down.
How does
it
go down?
No. Right one.
He's got
burned.
Kaden. Choose somebody else, Kaden.
Kaden.
You have
pen. Don't drop a pen.
Wow, you're doing very good.
It's alright. It's difficult.
Oh, there it is. Okay, it's gone.
You have to do one up.
If we're watching these points be plotted, we're gonna learn something.
No.
Yes.
X is the bottom one.
Brad, how could you? How could you?
Oh, you're. I was thinking of zero.
You just.
I can't see.
How many points do we have left?
One more.
Two.
One.
We got -2, 9. -2, 9. We got -1, 4. 0, 1. 1, 0. 2, 1.
So 3, 4.
So we got 3, 4. We got 1 point left.
Wait, how do you
cover everyone? Cover everyone.
Cover.
Boom.
There you go, there it is. Up. Press that.
Yes,
press that side button on the pen, close to the tip. Or do that. That'll work. Click on the pen. So close. There we go.
There we go.
Pick it up really quick.
I think I was pretty good. I'm pretty
sure
I was the champion.
I was pretty decent.
We all did decent to very well.
I did the best I could.
Like, see, that perfectly went on. Oh,
the one that was a pen line. Take care of that. Carter had a little straggler right there.
Oh, so then I'm going to be the
winner. I'm going to go ahead and redraw this.
Those are nice. Mine was perfect.
Yours is all right.
Not really.
There's a little guy down there. I'm like,
mine was perfect. I didn't draw anywhere else.
Now, listen.
Guys.
So the question comes up, how do I connect these, okay? And I want you, like I said last time, to stop thinking of graphs like that. Graphs are not points connected by a shape. The shape is...
The dots.
The shape is the dots. Okay? So if you want to know where the shape is, then you're going to have to either figure out or make a good guess of where the rest of the dots would be. Okay? Zach?
Oh, I was going to ask if I could do this.
Oh, no. Mabry?
I was going to ask if I could draw more.
Okay. So to make this point, I'm going to try and make this point in a different way. Say I want to connect the dots, okay? This is not a coloring book, it's not an activity book where you connect the dots, okay? But, if I were still in that mindset, here's how I would put answer person who said, like, how do they get connected? What, how do I connect? Do they get, you know, is it like this?
Nope.
Which I see. Now, the question, could it be? Well,
yes.
No, for a lot of reasons. But let me show you the most direct, most basic reason. Okay? I'm going to add a little more work here. Slide this over.
What?
You get 2.1. Now, what do you notice about 2.1? Its relationship to 2 and 3.
It's in between.
It is in between 2 and 3. So 2.1 is an x value. That's between the x value 2 and the x value 3. Okay. Now, if we were to do this, we need to know what we're going to do, but then we probably need a calculator to figure out the exacts. Right?
Probably.
So let's whip out a calculator. If you have a phone, you got a calculator. If you've got a, if you need to borrow one, I have calculators, but I bet you all, quite a few of you have a phone or an iPod or something.
What does AC mean?
You're probably hiding it behind your vertically standing binder texting on it a second ago, so go ahead and start using it as a calculator.
Aubrey. Was between 1 and 4. 1 and 4 are the numbers that we got when we plugged in 2 and 3. Okay? So we just found information that's going to help us plot another point, right? Yeah.
Another point. Well, let's keep going with this.
Oh, no.
Point 2. Okay? I think Robert's going to beat us all to the punch. He's like an Olympic calculator.
He's
a
computer.
Got it.
He got rid of all his hair, so now his brain can work.
I don't know. A lot of calculators have this capability, but I can just bring back what I plugged in before by hitting the second button and the enter button, and it just brings back up what I just entered. So I can just go back and go 2.2. I can change all the 2.1s to 2.2s. 1.44. What do we notice about 1.44?
Between
what?
1.21.
Yeah. I thought maybe someone would say between 1 and 4, but even more specifically, it's between 1.21 and 4. Good. Oh, well, I'm going to put that.
I almost said,
guys, gals, mostly those two guys back there that I'm looking at, but they're not
Yeah, Carter.
Here's, how would they know?
Carter, get in here, be quiet.
Carter, knock it off.
All right, about
more magic.
2.23.
2.23.
Oh, okay. There's no
more. Robert is going to beat me.
Yeah,
2.23 times 2.23.
Minus
2.23.
Oh, I got it. I beat you.
Really? What
yeah.
is it?
I got 1.5129.
That's what I got.
2.529.
Yeah.
Oh,
gotcha.
I got that too.
1.512.
Oh, no,
shut
this.
Up.
That's what I got.
I got
we're both. I can't
believe it's not right. It's pretty much
just like.
I'm
not.
I'm not.
I'm not.
Carter,
can
you please stop talking? Yeah.
Carter,
just
like
quiet.
Carter, look at this. People are trying to ask politely.
Go ahead. Joey.
Okay. Let's make it last in the class. Alright, so then we keep going, and I have 2.345. Now, wait, let's just hold on. Robert's just flying through, he's gonna do this anyway. I can't stop. But let's just think for a second. What kind of a number do you think we're gonna get here? What would you say that you could guess for pretty sure you know about this number?
I think it's gonna be
some kind of
decimal. Well, that's like a maybe guess. But
a decimal.
Okay, decimal. What about that decimal?
It's gonna be
between 2.23 and 3. You think this number?
Oh, no, I mean
1.5129.
Oh, whoops.
And 4. Who else agrees that this number that Robert's about to tell us is going to be between 1.5129 and 4? Have you agreement here?
Yeah.
Does anybody besides Robert have it?
I got it.
Let's give somebody else a chance.
You.
1.809.
1.809. What do you got, Robert?
Zero.
Oh, 0, 0.
No,
809.
0.809025.
Wow. Now, does that fit Aubrey's guess about this number?
Yes.
It is between 1.5129 and 4.
I bet all those ones that you have on there are going.
They're just gonna keep being between the previous number and 4, aren't
unless,
they?
Unless
they go past 3.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Point.
Or you go under 4.
Now hold on.
Two?
Let's make one last guess here about if I plug in 2.999999999. What's that going to be? Okay, incredibly close to.
It's
going to
be really close to
3.
No,
it's really close to
3.
It'll be really close to 2.
2.
What is this number really close to?
3.
But
what will this number be really close to?
3.
4.
We got it.
Well, what do we get when we plug in 3?
4, yeah.
What do we get when we plug in something
four.
Really close
four.
To 3?
No, 3.
So close to 4.
Well, let's see what Robert has to say.
It's between 1 and 2.
It's in between 1.809025
and 4. Yep. And it's 3.999996.
999996.
9, 6. How many
9s?
7 9s and 1 6.
4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 2, 1.
Well, I got different things.
Wow.
Could be right. Wait, is it kind of close? 3.999996.
Yes.
What'd you get?
3.999992.
How many nines did you put in the
2.99999? 8.
1, 2, 3. What is this? 8. I don't know. Maybe our calculators are
wrong. Yeah, I got
3.1.
Okay. Now here's the point I'm trying to drive home about graphs. How graphs are not scary things. Hey, graphs are not magic things. Okay? Stop packing up. I see you doing it.
Start.
I don't want to hear you doing it. Okay? What time this class over?
51.
No idea.
Give me a freaking break. Quit packing up.
Jesus Christ.
I'm gonna start talking. You can listen or whatever. 2-1, we know that. When we put in 2.1, which is just barely to the right of 2, no surprise, this number is just barely above 1. Right? So 2.1, 1.21. So that's about where that point would be.
And then just keep going like...
Yes, right? And that's, that shouldn't be too surprising. Because here's a point we already had. Here's a point we already had. And all the points in between, it would make sense if those points, as we can see, if we were to plot these all really precisely, they just keep climbing closer and closer. 2.99999 and 3.9999996. Okay? So, what if I keep doing this? If I keep plugging numbers between 2 and 3, what kind of...
It'll be a straight line of points. Well, it'll be like... It'll just keep going between.
Yes, it'll keep being between those two points. Now, the truth is, it won't. Those points won't form a straight line. They'll be slightly curved. But with any curve, if you look at a small enough section of it, it looks like a straight line.
Yes. Sir.
In fact, we are on an example of that right now.
Yeah.
Where are we on?
Straight.
We are on Earth. What is Earth?
Round.
Round. What does it look like here?
Flat.
It looks flat. You zoom in on a small part of your curve, it's going to look straight.
But it's not.
Well, this artificial floor probably is. But zoom out far enough, you're going to see overall.
So
hey, zip it. Shut your lips, Carter.
So if I spent all the time and all of the eternity, right, all eternity, I just wouldn't have enough time in 1,000 lifetimes to plot all of these points. But somehow I did.
I would get
kind of a shape like that. The thing about a graph is that it is a bunch of points, but when we realize that we don't have enough time to draw all those points, we draw a shape that we think those points will make. So when you ask me, what shape is this supposed to be, or how are they supposed to connect, I'm going to ask you to think about it this way and start trying to make guesses about where you think the rest of the points are going to be. Okay? That's the answer to that question. Now, always answer it that way until you get tired of hearing it and you finally give up and do what I asked you to do and guess where you think the rest of the points are going to be. I bet the points in between these points are going to be like this, and these ones are going to be like that, and these ones are going to be like this.
Harder! Oh my god, you ever shut up?
Like, these ones are going to be like this?
Yes.
At least this part of the graph looks like that. To get at what the rest of the graph looks like, out towards the right and to the left, we'd have to maybe find some more points, maybe ask ourselves, what do we think is going to happen as we plug in bigger numbers for x? And more negative numbers for x, right? And we have to look at the function and think, what's going to happen with this function as I plug things into it? But you know, that's for more advanced part of your math career. Because we are concentrated on a specific subset of graphs called lines. That's what we're focused on right now. We're having so much trouble grasping what these graphs are and their connection to the equations. So, I'm just throwing at you just some functions with some stuff in it and have you crunch the numbers and find those points and have you see that the graph is just a bunch of points. It's no big deal. When we come in tomorrow, we start back on graphing lines, okay? We're going to keep that in mind about what we're going to do knowing that graph. Or maybe observing first on one example, that's a line. We're going to look for key points to help us make the guess of where all the points are going to be accurately and quickly.
Right.
It's not about step 1, 2, 3, it's about hitting graphs and looking for those key points. Goodbye, have a good day.
I'll see you in